Well, here we go. It's about 1:30 a.m. in the morning. Let me check. Let me make sure I'm being accurate. Oh, it's 2:17, Monday morning, April 22nd. In the background, some nails and clothes, you know, folded. There used to be a picture here. If you go through my other videos, you'll see there's usually a picture here. That frame, I leaned back just like this, knocked it, and it fell in my eye. This eye. But I'm back 100% though. I think I'm back 100%. This eye was always funny. As you can see, it's not as open as the other eye. So I guess when I'm tired, this eye's a little bit closed. And part of being tired is that your eyelids, the muscles get weak. See, this is how it's supposed to be. But anyway, let me go close these doors. Yeah, so I haven't made a video in a long time. And I was just browsing the internet, specifically Instagram. Before that, I was on YouTube and I came across some videos about Nipsey Hussle. And it's tragic, you know? Kind of hurts my heart, man. That happened to Nipsey Hussle, because he had a very positive message going on. And, first thought, once you think you start to understand things about life, once you think you start to know a few things, you know, my first thought was it's a conspiracy. It was a hit. You know, he was being positive. He was out there preaching to his people about uplifting themselves. And that's what I'm all about, you know. I'm about uplifting yourself, ourselves, the individual self. And that's what he was about. And there's a lot of videos going around now, you know, trying to dissect what happened. Was it a conspiracy? Was it a hit? What it was? So I'm going to add my little 2 cents in. You know, one of the first things that caught my eye about the video was that the angle that the video came from. Now, we only have like 2 angles and they're all far away. And the marathon store, it was said that he owned the whole building. And I'm thinking it's not just the building that his store is in, but the entire complex. That's what I'm thinking. So a lot of things, you know, come to mind about that. You know, first of all, why are we getting a camera angle from way back where we can barely see anybody when there are cameras right in the store? I just watched the video where there are cameras right in front of the store. But one of the angles I had was that he was killed over ownership of the store, his interest in the store. He was killed because of that. The other angle is that, you know, it seems like there's a weird force out there. I don't know if it's weird, but a strong enemy, like he said, that's out there that's trying to keep a certain group of people in check. That's a possibility. I mean, it has happened throughout the recent history of America, and I'm talking about like 100 years, not just in America, but the recent history of the world. People have been taken out, and this is part of the game. You got to charge it to the game. This whole thing about life is a game, you know. So number one, he could have been killed over his ownership interest. Number two, he could have been killed because he was promoting positivity, and he had such a large platform because he was a celebrity rapper and he had the ear of hip-hop culture, which, you know, are the youth. That's another possibility. And I thought that about Tupac too. You know, he was killed because, you know, he was doing his thing and changing. But we're talking about Nipsey. And the other angle is that, you know, it was just street beef. You know, because the videos came up and, you know, people post things and it's basically just street beef. It could have been street beef. One rival gang against another rival gang. The thing is that we, as what you would call squares or civilians or whatever, non-gangsters, we think that when somebody rises up out of the hood, out of gangsterism, and try to change their lives, that now they're totally exempt. Their past, you know, is erased. You know, other gangsters or rival gangsters are just going to leave them alone. But it's not like that. They don't play by those rules, man. You know, they don't care about it if you're trying to uplift your life. You know what I mean? That's probably more reasons for them to try to take you out. So, I watched a few videos and, you know, there's no clear video. But anything could have happened. Anything could be happening. We don't know. I'm trying not to speculate too much, but I'm just giving my opinion. You know, I really don't know what happened, but he was a positive guy. You know, he was trying to do a lot of things from what I understand. I don't know, but just from face value, he was trying to do, you know, a lot of things. You know what I mean? So, it's just sad, you know what I mean? Like, just sad to see someone who's trying to do right go like that, you know what I mean? And it would be really, I mean, it's not far-fetched to think that there's a force out there trying to silence a certain group of people, or trying to keep a certain group of people down. It's not far-fetched. I mean, things have been going on throughout history, man. I mean, people have been wiped out by different plagues and diseases. You know, they had AIDS back in the 80s, wiping out people. It said that AIDS was manufactured by scientists and unleashed on in Africa and the black community and the gay community. And then you have Dr. Sebi. Nipsey Hussle was doing a documentary on Dr. Sebi because Dr. Sebi claimed to have cured AIDS amongst other things that we think are incurable. And then he died. And it was proven in court, Supreme Court, for that fact, according to Dr. Sebi, that he did cure people with AIDS and cancer and all this stuff. So, you know, you got to be careful when you ruffle with the, or you ruffle the feathers of the status quo, the establishment, the institution, the system. When you start to mess with the system, and the system is not a machine, the system of people who want to keep things the way they are. When you start messing with that, you know, it's naive to think that, you know, if I'm powerful, I'm just going to allow you to walk into my home and take my power. I'm not going to allow you to do that. You know, if I'm powerful, I'm not going to allow you to change things. I'm not going to want to share with you if you're, you know, if I think that you're going to try to step on my neck later on. So it's just a part of the game, and it's sad that Nipsey Hussle had to go like that. I mean, people are speculating that he's not dead. A lot of people are speculating that it was a hit. I mean, planned by who? Who knows that there was a white guy involved that got out of a car, handed the shooter a gun. And, you know, if you watch these videos, man, there's a whole bunch of conspiracy theories. And I'm not saying conspiracy theorists are crazy. I would say 9 times out of 10, the conspiracy theorists are probably the ones to listen to. The crazy people are probably the ones to listen to. But it's one of my, you know, first videos in a while. I just want to say, you know, respect to Nipsey Hussle. You know, I respect to his family, and, you know, just I appreciated what he did and what he was doing, and I appreciate a lot of people. I think what I'm going to start doing too, I'm at a spot on this channel where I highlight people in history who've done things that I admire. So once again, you know, let's get this shit done. do it now, not later. I'm out. Nice music. All right? Smarten up, wisen up. Knowledge is power. Let's get it done. Up a hill.